Now, if any members yet but one God is good. Nay, much more though never the body was seen to be more feeble or necessary, still.
And no member of the body was repaid to be less honored, for all these would be sure more honored than our common parts have more honored.
For our common parts have no need, but God has tempered the body together, having given more honor to that part that life is all. That there should be no skill in the body,
but that the
men
should have the same care
one for another. All right, you may be seated. Again, we thank God for our team here this morning. We thank God for our pastor. We thank God for you who is present this morning.
Amen.
We thank God that he has allowed us another chance, another day that was not promised to us, but God allowed us to have another one. And we realize it wasn't because we didn't do it either. Because God had been good. We also realize had justice dealt with us according to the deeds that we have done in these bodies, we would have been gone a long time ago and lost to hell damnation.
Amen.
But thank God, he's a just God and a merciful God. Now, in our study of the word, which is wrapped around the end time, we all realize that we are right in the midst of the end time. In other words, all the things that are going on now in our homes, in our communities, in our churches, lets you and I know that we are right in the midst of the end time. Don't worry exactly when it's coming. Just be sure that you are wrapped up in Christ. For we know without a doubt that we leave here wrapped up in Christ, we will spend eternity with him. We also realize that man now is calling right wrong and wrong right. God says abomination, but man says all right. I need to tell you, God will have the last say so. No questions or comments. Let's be off to the stage with our pastor. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine,
blessed us.
All right.
He's protected us. He wants us over us.
Amen.
And do you know that's what we're supposed to do, one another?
Yeah.
Protect and watch over one another?
Yeah.
Amen. Come about, study, and know what the Lord left here. Sister Lynn, that dear left out in front of me, and I'm right behind her. And I noticed she didn't have a license. Pitch black dog. She driving a pitch black car.
Sweet.
Amen. And I got right behind her to keep on getting a ticket.
Right.
Crawling up to the house.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Amen.
All right. Thank you.
And I think she thought I was trying to raise her. She stepped on it. I had to jump on my hand. I'm saying, I'm fine. Keep talking from getting a ticket. We are supposed to watch over one another.
Right.
We have to love one another enough to watch over one another.
Right.
I ain't gonna let nobody try to destroy you. Oh, Lord have mercy. That's why we gotta stand up together. Together we stand divinely. Any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. Not green, follow Jesus. Not Asian, follow Jesus. Not your near, follow Jesus. And we have allowed these things to hinder our growth. Every last one of us in here ought to be able to stay right now and pray for somebody. And God heal them. Every last one of us. But we got doubt even about ourselves. So how can you pray for somebody else? Our spiritual growth is not there. It's not there. We entertain too much foolishness. Too much foolishness. Somebody call them, you're on the phone with the foolishness, you ought to hang up. Amen. When people go to put the other folk down, hang up. Because if you don't, you're a part of that. You're a part of that. Amen. And just like we got to answer to God, you got to answer to God. And I keep telling you, I want to answer for stuff I'm doing. Not for what somebody else give me to do. Amen. I got my own mind. I can make my own decision. I'm grown. The church ain't my mama. Hallelujah. And each and every last one of us got to have our own mind. Let every man be fully persuaded in his own mind. But I'm afraid that we have so many that are being persuaded by others. By what others think. And what others say. Amen. Nebo, we got to do something. Changes has got to be made. It starts within us. Each individual got to make up your mind. I'm walking the way God will make me walk. I'm not going to entertain your foolishness. If you don't want to be here, you go. But as for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. How many are ready to serve God? How many? Ready to worship and praise God. In the early church, you understand that was 5,000 souls and 3,000 souls. And one day, what was the difference in then and now? Well, first difference is they knew they had a need. They knew they had a need. Amen. They was a view. They was going through and no way out. So they knew they had a need. Today we don't even know it. We don't realize we got a need. We wake up in the morning and we take it as if, well, it was going to happen anyway. I woke up this morning because God allowed me to. How many of you know you woke up this morning because God allowed you to? There was somebody that didn't wake up this morning. I have a need of him. When I'm going through, I need him to give me strength to get through. I can't do it by myself. So now the church is at a state where there are so many who think they want it. Amen. You got to come to church today, John today, and next week they want it. They know everything the church ought to do. Just got on board. Then you have those who've been in church for years, no Christian growth, but yet want to run the church. You cannot run a church if you don't have a vision for that church. But there's no vision. People perish. There has got to be somebody that's God is showing the way.
Yeah.
And the others has to follow.
Yeah.
All right.
How many of us know this?
Amen.
And know that God is showing the way, it always works. No matter who fights against it, no matter who's trying to stop it, it always works.
Yeah.
Because God is still in control.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Amen. Not saying that they didn't have any problem in the early churches. Mm-hmm. Amen. Paul had let it down the last day out of time.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Peter and the big woman. Told them, don't teach that name, don't preach that name no more. And when they left rejoicing for what they was able to suffer for Christ's sake.
Right.
But we don't want to suffer nothing. We want every day to be sunshine.
Right.
We don't want to be in the storm. We don't want to be in the rain.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
All right.
But the storm will come.
Yes.
Well, it's been in this church. That storm will come. Just when you think, when we think we got it made, and it's like everything is clicking, and we have got to sign ourselves, and we think we're better than everybody else, God step in and break it up.
Yeah.
That's right. In this walk of life, you can't get the big head. You got to humble yourself. Lord, thank you for using me. Thank you for who I am, because I know it's because of you that's why. I'm where I am.
Yeah.
Least. Mm-hmm. As least. As least. Are we having anybody?
Amen.
We complain about other churches and their growth. We're going to be looking in the wrong area.
Yeah.
If you remember this church, y'all be looking here.
Come on now.
Whatever they're doing down the street, that's between them and God.
Yes.
It's what we're doing here for God.
Yes.
Amen. 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 My house. I need to get my house straight.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I said my house because I got to get me straight first. Amen. Amen. Who going to bring us up to?
It was Ephesians chapter 5, verse 6. Learned that no moral reader person such as man is an idolator and has no inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. And learned, don't let no one deceive you with empty words, because God's wrath comes on those who are disobedient, so you shouldn't partner or pick up with them, meaning don't listen to the gospel and lie, because what you're supposed to, because you're just as guilty as them.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, that you're going to be judged for what you do.
Amen. Every individual,
amen,
is going to be judged for what they do. You won't be judged for what I do. But you will be judged for what you do. And that makes an issue.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to be judged for what I do and not for what you do. I don't make it on how you treat me. I make it on how I treat you.
Alright?
Amen.
I can treat you mean because you treat me mean.
Yes.
Alright?
That's right.
You know, we're going to go in the morning, well, you slap me, I'm going to slap you back. No. I have to be able to humble myself.
Alright?
Hello.
Right.
Amen.
Amen. I have to be able to humble myself. Because it's me that I got to answer for, not you.
Uh-huh.
If we could ever get that.
Amen.
Amen. We leave other folks alone. Amen. Amen. But we got to get there. That's what we call growth. Growth. Right. Look at somebody say growth.
Growth.
Amen. Amen. Anybody else?
We got to understand that we
here, still here, because he got us here.
Uh-huh.
And see, some of us think that when we get up in the morning, he had to wake us up. He ain't had to do nothing.
Uh-huh.
You could have laid right there, and then somebody found us, and we wouldn't have been woke.
Uh-huh.
But some people just think that. But for me, the storm and thing that I've been through in my life, I know what he do.
Mm-hmm.
And I know he good to me. Because I remember well, I didn't have nowhere to stay, nothing to eat. Mm-hmm. All I did, got on my knees and prayed to him. I let him know that you let me do this. I put on everything that I know to you. Uh-huh. That I would never forsake you. From now on, I will be there.
Right.
But you want me to be, and he did it. I'm still there. I'm gonna stay there.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Anybody else? Yes.
Oh yeah, I'm so glad that you taught us read and study.
Mm-hmm.
Know for yourself. That way when somebody is telling you something, you know if they tell you the truth or not.
Yes. Some of us are blessed because of the small things we did. Sometimes it just brings somebody some water. Amen. Anybody else?
Walk in love. That's what Jesus did when he died for us.
Amen. Walk in love. Walk in love. That's the other thing that the church is lacking in. Love. We talking. I said we talking.
Okay.
But we don't mean. And when you just talk, it's empty.
Yes.
When you love something, you try to pick it up.
Yeah.
You try to help hold it up.
Yeah.
Right? But when you don't love, every time somebody says something about that person, you jump right in. You want to hear. What's going on? Amen. And then turn right around and lie on you. All the cheap, but it takes money. My lady. Love is action. Love is doing. For God so loved the world that he gave. Doing. Amen. So what are we doing for one another? And love is not always money. Sometimes love just love that person. That's what we don't mean. You don't know what a person's been through this week. Don't be rolling your eyes at
me.
Amen. Amen. Why don't somebody roll their eyes at you? Whatever you do to us is going to be done to you. If we could ever get this. Anybody else, we're going to move on.
We should get rid of anger and it's slow to speak, but quick to listen to hear.
Amen. Quick to listen. Slow to speak. Quick to hear. Slow to speak. You know, some folk, you can't get a word in everybody.
Right?
Amen. Every time you go say something, you can make it on.
Yep.
That's what we do now. God's trying to talk and we come to talk. That's really just what we've got. God's trying to tell us something, and we come to God. Sometimes you gotta have some quiet time. Amen. Amen. You gotta get to the point where you can just be quiet and listen.
All impurities or greed but not to be named alone. And said, now when you are in love, love does not gossip about other sin, nor will they find pleasure in and satisfaction and discussing other people, And there should be no hostility, dirty stories, no filthiness name among you. Christians are not to indulge themselves in these things, but instead let there be thanksgiving. And you can be sure that no whoremongers, nor impurity, or greedy person who do these things can have no inheritance in Christ's kingdom.
Amen. Now we should be doing it. Our Lord said we should. But we have gotten so bold now that we don't care who knows.
With those deceivers.
If you can stand around and be party with somebody that's deceiving, then you're just as part of it as they. Listen, any Christian should not be involved in somebody else's wrongdoing.
All right.
This is like, this past night that one of my co-workers, she quit, okay? And I judge we have like three inspectors, okay? They all work together. But for some reason, they can't get along. There's one new lady, she just got there. You know what I'm saying? I think she may have been there maybe 2 or 3 weeks, and she already got pulled into what they had going on already back there. So, you know, me, I said my prayers. I'm not all busy and all this stuff. I can't come. Well, they all in the office. I'm like, in the office. I'm like, what? So, they was all trying to go figure out what they was in the office for. I was back there trying to pray, but they were crying. I was trying to go home. Mm-hmm. And I had worked earlier that day. So, I hear people work behind that one of them, you know what I'm saying, or whatever, you know. And I'm like, she quit for what? Because, you know, she got mad and all that, and, you know, all of they had going on. You know, and so, it's like, the new lady, she ended up, I guess, getting with the other one that was back there. They two sided against the one that's been there or whatever. And come find out, the one that's been there actually walked off, and she's the one that actually does the majority of the work. Mm-hmm. So now they're trying to figure out what they're going to do. So the supervisor, she came and asked me, you know, my daughter was working at part time, you know, if I would get her to come in, you know, and you know, fill in. And I was like, well, I only think I want to bring her HR on it because they already got so much going on already. For me to send her back there, that's just like sending her back there in the midst of what they got going on. So I don't think I'm going to tell her to call.
Yeah. Amen.
Right.
Amen. We shouldn't even be a party to our friends' sins.
Amen.
We got to live for our own.
Amen.
Right.
Then to add yourself into theirs.
Uh-huh.
Amen. You don't find pleasure in sin.
Amen.
We should find pleasure in
sin.
We got to be there for partakers with them. Many churches have been torn up because of kinship and friendship.
Mm-hmm.
Cliques.
All right.
If I don't like what's going on there, I'm gonna leave and I'm gonna take my partner with me.
Mm-hmm.
That means your partners ain't safe.
Amen.
All right.
If you don't like what's going on, that don't mean I'm gonna leave.
Mm-hmm.
You go ahead and leave. You don't have your own mind. Amen. 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 And the devil is a funny thing. He wants to pull as many as he can with it because he can't stand alone.
All right.
Right.
Amen.
Amen. So he wants as many with him as will go. But we should not be partakers with men. Verse 8.
For you were once darkness, but now you are
the
light in the Lord. Walk as children of light.
For you were sometimes, huh? Or once darkness. You weren't saved. You didn't know no better. But now that you're saved, there ought to be some changes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's not what things I used to do.
I don't
do no more. Why? Because I'm saved. Where I used to see things, I don't see them that way anymore. Why? Because I'm saved. I've been in light. I knew I was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
What is it? In dark. But now are ye what? Light.
Mm-hmm.
In what? In the Lord. Listen, people are watching you. And they ought to be able to see Christ in us.
Mm-hmm.
People ought to be able to see Christ in us. In fact, you are the only Bible that some folk gonna read.
Uh-huh.
And if we're doing wrong and throwing stuff out of the light for everybody to see it, how is they gonna know to come to Jesus?
Yeah.
We're different.
All right.
If we've been born again, we're different.
Mm-hmm.
We're no longer missing.
Amen.
We want peace. We want joy. We want love.
Right.
But that's what I want.
I do too.
Uh-huh. I want peace.
Mm-hmm.
When you have peace, your blood pressure settles down.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
you at peace?
Yeah, yeah.
Your eyes stop being blurred because of your high blood pressure.
Yes, sir.
And I only tell the next kids, put me in the grave. When I get that, I'm going to call God on me. Peace. Peace. We shouldn't even be living in a house where there's no peace. God has called us to love and to peace.
Right.
In the Lord, walk as children of light. Mm-hmm. What do light do?
Shine bright, let you see.
Allow you to see. The world ought to be able to see in us that God is real. You don't handle your problem like everybody else.
All right.
You don't go along with mess like everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
When you're saved, you can go and work in other homes, and they'll know there's a difference in you. You don't go in their house trying to take over. They pay you to do a job, do the job they're paying you for.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
And sometimes even a job they ain't paying you for.
Uh-huh.
I don't do witness. What if you had just come? They didn't even see Christ.
Alright,
you'll be okay. They will be able to see Christ in you.
Mm-hmm.
And they will be able to say, that person is different.
All right.
She ain't like other black folk that I've met.
Mm-hmm.
She's humble. And that don't mean that you put yourself in a position where you ain't nothing.
All right.
That just means that you put yourself in a position where you're somebody.
Because I'm here.
Amen. Yes, yes. And I thank God that He has made me who I am. Because a lot of stuff I've been through, I wouldn't have gone through.
Yes, man. I know what you're talking about.
And like I said, you know, when you mess with people, you don't know what state of mind they're in.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
Amen. That people who lost their life because they messed with a person at the wrong time.
You know,
you know
the people
say,
oh, he's dead, he didn't
do
this
or
do that.
Mm-hmm.
You don't mean they're scared.
Well, I'm scared, but I'm still
living.
Yeah, all right. I mean, call me what you want. But I ain't going to take me some coffee. I want to do everything that's going to bring may not be able, they hadn't reached perfection yet, but I'm trying to get to a point where I'm going to do everything to please God.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Go up outside Paul.
Mm-hmm.
And put on the baby.
All right.
When I find out what's wrong, I put it on.
Yeah.
All right.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Help me, Lord. Help me.
Help
me, Lord.
Help me, Lord.
Help me, Lord.
I need you.
Yes,
sir.
That's why I mean, when you're living in truth and you are the light, a lot of people don't want to be around you.
Yes.
Because it shows them up for who they are.
Right?
If you're walking with God, and somebody's not walking with God and can be around you in peace, something wrong.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I knew this from personal experience.
Yeah.
Before I met God, I didn't want to be around folks anymore.
Yeah.
Right.
Because they were not up to what I was up to.
Yeah.
And every time I did something, they showed me up for who I was.
Yeah.
When I said I can't stop, they don't stop. How many get this?
Yeah.
So then, we need to provide what is acceptable under the Lord. Fussing and fighting amongst ourselves is not acceptable. pull them out of the light, draw them out, let folks see. Because if you don't, it never will stop.
Right.
If you don't, it never will stop. In fact, there should not be anything done in the church under the table.
Right.
Under the table means it's being deceptive, you being a deceiver. There are those who do not know what the church has.
All right.
If you build this church, you ought to know what they got.
Yeah.
You ought to know what it's being used for.
All right.
Because we're not doing it under the table. A good sign that things are going wrong is when things have been done. I'm going to tell you.
All right.
See, when I'm right, I don't care what you do.
All right.
That's right.
It's just when I'm wrong.
Will it come out?
Yes, it'll come out.
Right.
Men will be darkened in light because their deeds are evil. Whenever evil is going on, I want to keep it under. Somebody's up to down low. Don't want nobody to go, shh. But God sees.
Right.
He can't hide nothing from him. His eyes is in every place, beholding the evil and the good. He sees it all. Christians do not touch things that's done in secret.
All right?
We don't walk around trying to dig it up, analyze it,
all right,
see what's going on, because it's going to affect me.
All right?
If I'm going to dig up anything, I need to be digging up what's in my life.
Yeah.
Dig it up. Now, if you get to digging in your life, you find out that there's some bones there. There are some skeletal remains there if you get to dig it in your own land.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I heard somebody say, some of them still have meat on the bone. Stop talking about stuff. The folks have done it in secret.
All right.
But now they do it openly, you can see it. Talk about it. Turn the lights out, close all the doors, you won't be able to see these people. Because there's no windows.
Amen.
All right.
If there were windows, there would be light coming in through a window. It would reveal what's there. How many of us get this?
Right.
So then if you're part of God, your light ought to reveal what's wrong. And the problem that need to be checked, your life ought to reveal that. Because whatever is in the life is made manifest. You ever been walking in the woods at night? You ever been walking in the woods at night? Away in that murder? Huh?
I walk in the daytime.
Amen. I walk in the room at night. You walk into some stuff. I remember growing up in Monesville, we didn't have running water. We had to go down to the spring to get water. Brother and I, sometimes we didn't go during the day, so mom made us go at night. Now, there was a trail that goes down to the spring. How many of you is clean? It's clean. But we decided one night we were going to go around another way. Step in the stuff, ran in the stuff. Because we got off the main trail. That's what's happening to the church. We just got off the main trail and just started trying to make a new trail. The Mike said, when you find the old path, walk there. It's time to go back.
All right.
Light. Light. The church ought to be a light. A light. Church should have all this torque in it. The women shaking. And I saw something, and they took the podium down, and they all in the pool, and bounced.
All right.
Old folks sitting there with their mouth open. Out. Ain't saying nothing. You supposed to be like, you supposed to stop. Amen. They had one church giving a tribute to Prince.
Anyway, and it was some elders that were there, and then we came, and just like mama was there, so if you got any thoughts on Mr. Head, whatever, They got the preacher jobs, preaching arms, you know what I'm saying? They had no family that they could get us with. You know, so it was just like she was there.
Yeah.
By the time we made it back home, I got out that bus, she had a full report of what was done, what was said, who had it out, who gonna get it when they get back. That's the way it used to be back in the day. It's not like that now.
Can you see how far we've come from being back?
Amen.
Come on, let's see.
Alright.
Now, we allow children to go to up church, but when they get in trouble, we want to bring them here to get them out of trouble.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Now, if they're going to go to another church, that church ought to support them.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But they have these other ones with the big churches that when you come through the door, they want your tax returns and all that when you're coming in. And they're giving to them.
Yeah.
But they'll come here and expect you to do, you know, those churches. Because they don't have time, because they too busy to fly here and there and they're here.
Amen. Well, they come out of charge of weddings.
Exactly.
And funerals.
Amen. And that's exactly why they do it.
Amen. But you, sometimes you just got to stop that confusion.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yes, 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 yes. If I ain't good enough for you to come to my house, and you ain't good enough for you to come to your house. My daddy told me something. And don't say my daddy lied, because I know he didn't. He said, if you always call somebody and they never call you, they trying to tell you something.
No,
okay. Right. If you always calling somebody and they never call you, they trying to tell you something. If you calling me and I don't call you, stop calling.
Let's break briefly before morning service. Thank you all.